today we were blessed to get some apples. So we got about 60 pounds of apples in. We just nice organic apples. You can tell that they're not the high quality. They're the kind of the seconds. And what we've decided to do is do three different things with them. So first off, we separate them into the ones that we're going to eat pretty quick because they're going to go bad and they're small. The other part is we're going to separate them out, some of the nicer ones, but they're just pretty small for the peeler. Really, I mean, they're just small, but they'll actually taste real good. We've already eaten a few, so we're going to keep those. And then the ones here on the table, what we're going to do is we're going to go ahead and core those and peel them. And then we'll take that and split it into two different parts. So we've got this little peeler here. It's just a simple little apple peeler. Back to the basic brand. It's real nice. It's got just a suction cup base on it. Works real well. And everything we've seen so far with it as far as irregular shaped apples and all that stuff. First time I've ever used it, but we've owned it for 3 or 4 years. Most of the time, I'll be honest, I always just cut them up by hand. But this year we got quite a few, so decided we would do something with those. And the peels and the cores, we're putting them down here in a bucket. So we just clean and sanitize a nice bucket. By the time it's done, we're expecting to have probably, you know, 3 to 4 gallons worth of peels and cores. We're just going to fill that up with some water out of our Berkey, put a little sugar in it, a little apple cider, and then we're going to go ahead and make our own apple cider. We go through huge amounts of this in the wintertime, not only for ourselves but for our animals. So we decided there's nothing better to do with it than that. And then you can look in this bucket here, and we've got all the nice slices. We've got all these nice slices here, and we're going to go ahead and take these and can them yet today. So pretty busy day. Like I said, we're going to process about 60 pounds of apples, and we're going to do it in a manner that allows us to use everything. And then when we're done, after 2 or 3 weeks, we'll pull those cores and the skins out, and then that'll be a good little food for our chickens too. So expecting to use it all. We'll show you a little bit of our operation here. Again, thanks for watching. Hope you're doing these fun things like that on your homestead with your family and kids, and just enjoying the beautiful fall weather. Thanks. Shalom.
Water with lemon juice, and I went ahead and added about 2 cups of sugar to it. They just weren't very sweet at all, so we're trying to avoid doing that, but figured we'd go ahead and do it anyway. And we're gonna have to put them in a water bath for 20 minutes for quarts. So this is gonna be our first batch, and we've got more jars in the dishwasher going. We're gonna have quite a few jars, so we'll let you know the final count when we're all done. Thanks for watching. Shalom.
Okay, so this is not, we actually forgot to take the scene showing the when we were putting in the water and everything, but what we ended up doing, this is again a 6 gallon pail. We have about 5.5 gallons of water. I'm sorry, 5 gallons of water in here from our Berkey. Also in that, I put 2 cups of organic sugar, and other than that, you know, just covering it with a cheesecloth. It's the only way we've been doing that. And once a day, I've just been coming in here and stirring it. But before I stir it, and you can come down in here and look, and you can see all the bubbles. So it's starting to, I guess, to do its fermentation process. If you come down in here low, it really, you can, I wish I could describe it to you, but I mean, it's just that initial part of that apple cider, you know, when you're a little bit away from the jug and your olfactory senses just take over and you can kind of just know that you're going to get some apple cider. That's what it smells like. It's just amazing. And this is 3 days afterwards, so you can see the nice crisp brown color on top. So what we're doing is, all I'm doing is just coming down in here now, pulling out some of the stuff that hasn't really sat on top, just stirring it around, pushing some of that browner apples down into the bottom, and just mixing it all around. So I give it a good little stir, and then I just simply cover it back up with the cheesecloth, and we're expecting in about 10 days from now, we'll actually take the same cheesecloth and I'll just strain out all the apple cores and all the peels. Like I said, you know, it's a dual purpose. I'll monitor it out for a few days and give it to our chickens. So this should help them. I'll probably put a little diatomaceous earth in with it, and this will just get them pretty much an early deworming process for the year. And it'll be such a treat for them. They'll be excited. And I'll be excited that they're going to go into the fall just nice and healthy. So again, this is how to make apple cider vinegar. And like I said earlier, you know, in the earlier part of the video, I hope you're taking the time to do this with your children. I really think across this country, we've just given up on the opportunity to train our children and possibly what could be a situation that, you know, they may want to learn, or, you know, may have to teach other people. So hopefully you'll take this time to educate your children, whether they're old, out of the house or not. I'm sure they'll still come back if they're close, and if not, when they come back, schedule to do it with your grandkids. Thanks again for watching. Hope you're having a great week. Shalom.